Dutch and Italian on a Brava. Mahalo and welcome all blessed Brava babies to this perfectly attuned transformation. Oh, transmutation, transformation on a Monday. Yes, she is wearing her pre-fight robe in deep honor of her biggest, newest crush, Conor McGregor. Say what you want. The man has a way with words. Don't understand any of them, but love them. Love his turn of a phrase. This Be Brava transmutation is entitled Be Brava Live, Hummer. Hold for straw. Be Brava Live, Hummer. She could have called it good had, but she is a poet after all. Okay, cuties, we're gonna get right the fuck into it. So for the longest time, Be Brava Live, Hummer, for the longest time, she was doing her transmutations with the refrigerator. Yes, we know you're in a she's in a tiny house, okay, cuties? This is not a Taylor Swift estate over here. This is a Brava tiny home. It's 2 feet to the fridge, okay, cuties? She was doing her transmutations with this dull hum beneath her, okay, cuties? And then she had the aha to unplug that shit for the 10 minutes that she's here for you live. My darlings, this is what we speak of when we speak of Be Brava Live Hummer this afternoon. What is the hum? What is the noise? What is the background that has just become normalized for you? And we all seek that hum fucking state where we're not looking, asking, searching for niente, where we actually experience a quieting of the mind. We seek it, how cuties? Through exhaustion, through fatigue, through working out too damn hard, through working through the weekend, 20 years on Wall Street, when will I get to the place of hum state where I don't have to think and I can just be there? Or we get there through escapism, opioid, epidem, my cuties, alcohol. My mom used to do this thing. It was so cute. She would just be like, total working mom move. She would just be like this. And I'd be like, Mom. And she'd be like, oh, sorry. She would, like, fall into this, like, little escapism moment. We were like, I swear her body would, like, be there, but her body would leave her physical form, and she'd just be looking over house and children from a distance, and we'd have to snap her back into her physical body. You know, this is the thing, my darlings. The previous gen didn't have access to all the understanding that we do now, cuties. The next gen is, like, lit as fuck. Jade is shaving her head because Willow told her to. Willow told her mom to shave her head, and then Willow told her, then Jada did. This is exemplar numero one of, like, how the next gen, as exemplified by Willow Smith, voice of her gen, we know this, is showcasing the way, okay, cuties? Because, like, my mother, her parents, they would let the kids just, like, line up and huff at the gas tank because, like, the kids liked the way it felt. Okay, cuties, they didn't know about taking their children to meditation classes. They were huffing at a gas station in New Jersey. Whole for working farm. Thank you. Tully Brava on the farm says, please shut the fuck up while I spew my grill. Okay, dogs. So we seek this hum state. We seek good head, okay, cuties? And we seek it in many different ways because we don't know how to get there. Okay, I'm going to say something that is so fucking humiliating. And if any of you parse this out and just, like, put this as a little soundbite, thank you. But also, like, how dare you? So she really discovered what spirituality was. The first time she actually experienced that was in a yoga class. I know, so basic. Yoga works of all basics, basic places to be found on the Upper West Side. Her first ever yoga class, she understood, she had this moment where she was like, oh, this is where people go to church. And so for the longest time, the only way that I thought I could get there was through the body, you know, through physical practices, which is a way, through meditation is a way. There are all these ways to get to that hum state. We've all experienced it at least for 1 second, right, cuties? Whether it be induced by maybe alcohol, drugs, or exhaustion, or through meditation and maybe a more true grounded version of it, right? More organically accessed, more easily to return to without those. Okay, cuties? We've all experienced one moment of the hum state, and the hum state really is where you're like, recognize that the fridge is off. you recognize that the fridge sound is off. And you can actually hear noise for noise and make that distinction. And then, my cuties, here's the thing. We all are so addicted to our little chattery brains, and we fear that we will lose our energy. We won't have motivation, right, cuties? Everyone fears this because it's like, it's akin to switching to ketosis, okay? There's a different energy system in the body that is running off anxiety or true inspiration. When we're in our parasympathetic nervous system, rest and restore, we actually have access to more energy, not less, my cuties. However, we need to assimilate in the body to work with this ease, my jars. She says as she sips her cold brew. No, she's not there. Okay, cuties. Who said she was there? Okay, cuties, I'm not Eckhart, all right, jars? Actually, I'm a deeply aggressive, like, very competitive, psychopathic human, okay, cuties? And that's why I can speak to you, because I understand my babies. So, cuties, she's not there. But the place is this place where we actually have access to more energy, not less. And we've all accessed at certain points. So, but the thing is, my jars, when you first touch into meditation practice or calming down the nervous system, the only time the body has ever closed its eyes and felt a sense of quiet and stillness, it was sleeping, okay, cuties? So most people, when they start meditation practice, they nod off all the time. However the fuck er, once you have that kundalini rising, cuties, in your meditation practice, you could reach mania. Oh, dars. Sheila Vipassana early, do not recommend it. But I had to get to my Dom training, okay, cuties? And when you enter Vipassana, two things happen. One, you write out, you sign a fucking contract that says you will not leave early. And then you speak out loud, I will not leave early. You literally make a vow in like a cafeteria to like a group of strangers. And then, my darlings, the next thing you do, you vow to not lie. Ugh. So she was like lying to Buddha or Goenge or whoever the fuck, whatever. Okay, cuties, she was lying to spirit animals across the plains of the Vipassana Center all week. I promise I won't leave, knowing full well she was leaving because she double booked herself because she had to go to Dom training. Okay, cuties? So she left Vipassana early. I had to like beg at the feet of this like nunnery. Like literally the nun like lets you in and then you have to like go beg at her feet. And she was like, you're weak-minded. And I was like, bitch, I know. I gotta leave early though. So I left early. 4 a.m. in the morning, they were like, leave in the cloak of dark. We don't want you distracting the other meditators. Oh, cults, my booze. Only invent your own cult and then join my cult. Okay, only join my cult. Don't join other cults. Whatever they call themselves. So, Dars, Whole Foods is a cult, I swear. It's a real bit. Whole Foods is such a cult. And I know this to be true because one time I stole from a Whole Foods and they brought me into their back room. It was just a vitamin water and a nectarine, okay, cuties? They brought me into their back room. There's like 3 guys. They're like, if you don't stop shaking, we're going to send you to the precinct. But I thought they said penitentiary, so she was shaking. Anyway, Stars, point being, if they don't let you leave, it's a call. So Vipassana doesn't let you leave. I had to leave in the cloak of dark. But I was high as a motherfucker, okay, cuties? Off my own damn energy, okay, cuties? So when you think that meditation is going to make you sleepy, oh no, if you leave Vipassana early, you might be manic. You might be inventing songs and leaving voicemails to friends about how you want to make an album with them. Mm-hmm. And none of them got back to me. Hello, cuties, stop tweeting you. I had a whole song called Van Life. Yeah, it was great. It was a really, and then the other one was All I See Is Broken Boys. I sent the Van Life one to a broken boy who never got back to me. I sent the All I See Is Broken Boys to Grace Lusk, who did get back to me. Mahalo, Grace. Okay, cuties, the hook is All I See Is Broken Boys. Okay, cuties, it's true. I don't know if they come broken to me or they break when they get to me, but they're all broken. So, Dars, the hum state, that state of calm, that state of actually discerning between noise and not noise. We are so used to the refrigerator hum. We are so used to the mental chatter, so I will dare say addicted to the mental chatter, that we continue to fill it up. Okay, cuties, if you are like me, hello, and your Spotify is constantly on, constantly learning. I want to learn more. And now I want a beat. And I want a heavy fucking beat. And now I want like some female rappers. Okay, cuties. If your Spotify is forever, you have a hum problem. You need to get more good head. We're getting good head today. Okay, cuties. So there is the ways. We go by escapism. Escaping the body through drugs, alcohol, staring off into the dust. We go through exhaustion, fatiguing. Okay, if I just work harder and harder and harder, at the end of the day, I'll be so tired that eventually I'll reach hum state. Can we get there faster? Can we speed to home? Yes, cuties. Can we get to some roadhead? All right, Dars, let's roadhead the fuck out of this motherfucker. Meditation. Also, my Dars, maybe there is something to telling yourself that you fucking deserve it, that you fucking deserve a break from all the mental noise. And when you're in that state of calm and quiet, you take away your addiction to the mental chatter. What appears out of seemingly nowhere, seemingly you're on a walk in the park, and then all of a sudden, an idea pops. And I am not a fucking brain scientist, but I will tell you that idea comes from someplace deeper and better than the baseline hum. Does it not, my Dars? Does it not come from somewhere deeper, better, stronger? The great ideas come to us when we are in that quiet state. And in fact, my Dars, the brain's chemistry needed for a new aha moment, which means two disparate items in the brain coming together for creativity, that's what creativity is relaxed and slightly happy. Shower moments, nature walks, okay, Dars? Getting that good head on a daily basis and maybe living there a little longer. All right. I have a note to self. Tits deep in cold brew. I don't even know where that's, what apropos of niente, but always. Okay, cuties. So, publish or perish. All right, cuties. As we now know, it's like gram it or get off, right? Gram or get off. Dars, we know this to be true. We're all fucking addicted and we see it with each other, right? People might have, some creative, like great juicy shit happening. And then the next day it's basic. I am number one guilty of it. Okay, cuties, I have this need to continue to produce that sometimes I produce when the shit is basic as fuck. Okay, cuties, and it's not coming from inspiration. It's coming from an anxiety to produce, right? My darlings, we cannot replicate anything. The lie of the brain will tell you that great American ethos, okay, that humans are corporations too. Humans are corporations. That is the lifeblood from which we Americans are birthed onto the soil that we stole, cuties, right? Humans are corporations, which means same rules apply. Produce, or if you're not growing, you're dying, right? My Dars, what's your 10-year exponential growth plan to continue to create more fucking viral content? No, stop. Shut the fuck up with that bad brain. Bad head, get out of here with your teeth, right, cuties? Too much teeth. Your snarl. When we are in our parasympathetic nervous system, when we are in that rest and restore, when we are in that hum state, we don't seek, need, or want anything. Maybe we've accessed it for 5 fucking seconds. You know what that is. You know what that is. You can act out of inspiration, not desperation. And so today she was deeply inspired. Yesterday's transmutation, that was shit. Okay, cuties, I'm the first to say it. It was shit. She had to delete it? No, because I want you to feel the difference. Feel the difference, okay, Dars? You need inspiration and desperation. And wake up every day a little closer to hum state. Now here's one little Talia tip. Yes, Vipassana is 9 days. I mean, by the time you finish it, you're never going to stop talking about it because it's a big, huge, massive brag. It's like in New York. They'll let you know in 30 seconds whether they did Vipassana or they're from New York. Okay, cuties, we get it. What's hard, we like to talk about. And Mark Nepo, poet, he wrote a poem. Oh my God. I'm like literally quoting a poet and speaking about yoga class. Basic bitch, call it at me. Mark Nepo, there's a poem, and I'm not going to read it to you, but the gist of the poem, you're so welcome. I love my illiterate babies. If you had one breath, how would you take it? Okay, darlings. So in your meditation practice, let's just say right now, we're not even going to do a meditation practice. Let's just say right now that you have one breath to go there, one breath to drop in. Right now, breathe in. And exhale. And maybe that's enough to enter hum state and get that good, good head. All right, my darlings, so grateful for your presence. I love that my actual birth father was here for this transmutation. Everybody needs good head. That's all she wrote. Find your hum state. and be Brava. Build Your World is starting the beginning of August. Hello, my darling Leighton. The robe I spoke of is a tribute to my boyfriend to be Conor McGregor. You know what I love about the UFC, my darlings? Is it really does show you the art and zen of beating the crap out of someone on a global stage. And also, my cuties, you see them in their zone state, right, cuties? I love all Brava babies getting into their zone state. Whatever gets you there, find your hum. She better go and turn the fridge back on because, as you know, she's on the carnivore diet, so I have like a fridge full of meat that is like deeply defrosting. Join for Build Your World. We're going to launch your big go. It's going to be a blast working with my altar, Lucia Brizzi. Ugh, and Stella.